Hello everyone, today we are going to Meteora. You probably have heard of this place because this is, I would say, probably the most well-known place here in this region of Greece. A lot of people from all over the world come and visit Meteora because of the very unique cliff sides and mountain sides here, and of course the monasteries. So we're gonna go and check out Meteora. I'm joined here today by my friend Giorgo, who lives nearby. We've known each other for many years, so we're gonna go together up here to Kalabaka and Meteora.
Ναι.
Οι φωτογραφίες που ανεβάζεις μου αρέσουν, είναι πολύ ωραίες. Και όσοι θέλετε να τα δείτε, να πάτε να τον ακολουθήσετε στο Instagram.
Σε ευχαριστώ πολύ για τα καλά σου λόγια.
Τίποτα. Meteora is a very unique area here in central Greece where there are cliff sides, like the kinds that you see behind me, that have monasteries on top of them, and in some cases sort of carved inside the cliff sides. This was an area where hermetic Orthodox monks came about 1,000 years ago, but there's also some evidence of life here up to at least 10,000 years ago. So area to come and hide out because it was very hard to get to, and in some cases you can only get to some of the spots here by ladder. So it was inhabited by people who purposely wanted to isolate from people, wanted to go to a place that was hard to get to and hard for other people to get to and disturb their peace. Quite remarkable. And this is why people come and visit here, because not only do you have the geological stuff that is really cool here, but you also have the monasteries and the human history involved with this area. There actually is a road that comes up to here if you go to the town of Kalabaka, the main town of the area, and then go around the mountain through a smaller village called Kastraki. Continue on through there, and then there's a road that comes up to this area that we're at here in Meteora that we're driving up. There are plenty of great hiking trails around here. There's even rock climbing here, but if you want to just take a drive up the road here and make it a little bit easier, or at least less physically challenging, you can definitely do that, and that's basically what we're doing. Αυτός ο δρόμος που ανεβήκαμε πηγαίνει πιο ψηλά.
Ναι, ναι, συνεχίζει, θα πάμε κι άλλο πιο πάνω. Mm. Θα ανεβούμε και στο μεγάλο το μοναστήρι που έχει εδώ πέρα.
Ναι, αυτό που είναι πίσω μας, δεν ξέρω άμα φαίνεται. Να, αυτό εκεί πίσω. θα ανεβούμε εκεί πάνω και ναι, από εκεί φαντάζομαι θα έχει πάρα πολύ καλή θέα, γιατί ναι, θα είναι πολύ ψηλά.
Είμαστε ακόμα πιο ψηλά.
Λίγο κρυουλάκι εδώ πάνω.
έχει λίγο ψυχρούλα.
Όσο πιο ψηλά πάμε, λογικά, ειδικά τώρα που είναι και χειμώνα, όσο πιο ψηλά πάμε, τόσο πιο πολύ φυσάει και έχει κρύο.
Ναι.
This monastery is on a different cliff than the one that we parked and walked over here from. So there's like a little thing here that sort of joins the two cliffs so that you can go across. And then there's other cliffs that are joined by cable cars. And actually this one kind of has a cable car thing up there. It's and it goes from the other side where the parking is, and it goes there, but I think it is closed today. We saw a sign that said Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, it's closed, and it's Thursday today on the day we're filming this. Even though it's closed, it's still cool to see just from the outside, just to come here and see it right here from the outside. Even if the weather is very changeable and windy and cold like it is today, it's still really cool to see up close. All right, so the weather is kind of, it's not totally cooperating with us. It's kind of going between sun and clouds and rain, and then sun and clouds and rain and wind. So we're getting lucky sometimes, but then in between different spots that we're stopping along our drive around Meteora here, it starts raining.
Τώρα συνεχίζουμε πιο ψηλά να δούμε.
Αυτό το σημείο είναι πάρα πολύ ωραίο εδώ πέρα.
Yes, you're literally on the cliff here, so watch your step, especially if it's wet. At first when you see them you kind of wonder, what is this and is this a way to get to the monastery? But you see that you can't actually enter the area where you can get these cable cars because it's, you know, it's basically people who work here in the monasteries who use them. So, still cool to see though.
Τώρα θα κατεβούμε στη Γκαλαβάκα κάτω, θα πάμε να τσιμπήσουμε κάτι. Πώς σου φάνηκαν?
Μου φάνηκαν πολύ ωραία. Είναι κάτι που, εντάξει, έχω δει τόσες φωτογραφίες και βίντεο μέσω ίντερνετ από εδώ, αλλά...
Οπότε ήταν σαν να βλέπεις αυτά τα... τα μέρη, σαν να σου ήταν.
Όχι, εντάξει, δεν θα έλεγα ότι είναι σαν να τα ξαναβλέπω, γιατί πάντα είναι διαφορετικά.
Σίγουρα.
Το βλέπεις από
κοντά. Όταν είσαι από κοντά, πάντα όλα είναι. Τα ναι. Βλέπεις πολύ.
Αλλά είναι ωραία. Κάτι που. Εντάξει, κάτι ήξερα πριν έρθω. Down to Galabaca, decided just to get a little simple gyro that I'm dropping some meat down for these two dogs that are right here. Don't worry, the dogs will eat it, so it won't, the meat won't won't go to waste, because these dogs know that you know, people walking down with a gyro, sometimes they'll get a little something from someone. But anyway, we just decided to come down here to Galabaca, right down here from next to Meteora, to get a little bite to eat, and then head back to and then head to Tricala, and go and chill there for the rest of the day. But that's pretty much it from here. Η Καλαμπάκα,
εντάξει, δεν έχει από μόνο του κάτι πάρα πολύ εντυπωσιακό. Είναι απλά ότι είναι κοντά στα Μετέωρα.
Ναι, είναι στα Μετέωρα δίπλα. Εντάξει, είναι όμορφη πόλη.
I had always wanted to go and see Meteora, and had always wanted to go and make a video in Meteora because it's very picturesque, and I can see why that is the most well-known place from this region in Greece, in central Greece. But we'll leave it at that for now, so thank you everybody for watching. See you guys on the next video.